Our next problem is a very good combination of a circle and an ellipse. We are given that if an ellipse x square by 16 plus 11 y square by 256 is equal to 0 and the circle this are having a common tangent, then we need to find the point of contact of the tangent with the ellipse. Now these kind of problems are always solved by either writing the equation of tangents for both the curves, that is the ellipse and the circle, and then comparing them, or what we can do is we can write the equation of tangent for one of the curves and then put y in terms of x or x in terms of y in the other curve and make the discriminant equal to 0. These are the two methods which we apply when we are having a line which is tangent to two curves. So what we'll do is we have the ellipse x square by 16 plus 11 y square by 256 is equal to 0. Any general point on this ellipse will be equal to 4 cos theta, comma 16 by root 11 sin theta. Any general point? So tangent is equal to x x1 by a square plus y y1 by b square is equal to 0, or rather 1. So this is equal to x into x1. This is the equation of tangent divided by 16 plus y into y1, which is 16 by root 11 sin theta is equal to 1. So this becomes, on solving, 4 cos theta x plus root 11 sin theta y is equal to 16. This is the equation of tangent. Now we can apply any one of the two methods which we discussed earlier. Either we can write the equation of circle, equation of tangent for the circle now, and then compare it with this equation, since there is a common line which is tangent to both the circles and the ellipse. Or what we can do is we can put y in terms of x in this equation and put discriminant is equal to 0. But over here, since our special curve is a circle, so what we can do is, in case of tangent, if we draw perpendicular from the center upon this tangent, then it is equal to r. So we can draw perpendicular from the center of the circle on this tangent and we can equate it to the radius of the circle. We can also apply the other two methods that we discussed. The center of the circle is 1, 0, hence dropping a perpendicular from 1, 0 on this, we get 4 cos theta minus 16 upon under root of 16 cos square theta plus 11 sin square theta is equal to the radius of the circle, and with the radius of the circle we know is equal to 4. This 4, 16 and 4 gets cancelled. We can square both the sides to get the equation cos theta minus 4 whole square, that is cos square theta plus 16 minus 8 cos theta is equal to 16 cos square theta. We can make the entire quadratic in terms of cos theta, so this we can convert it in cos theta again. This becomes 11 minus 11 cos square theta. So this becomes 5 cos square theta and cos square theta. So this becomes 4 cos square theta plus 8 cos theta minus 5 is equal to 0. This we can write as 10 cos theta minus 2 cos theta minus 5 is equal to 0. This gives us cos theta is equal to half, or theta is equal to plus minus 60 degrees. And hence we wanted to find out the point of contact of this tangent with the ellipse. The point of contact is 4 cos theta comma 16 upon root 11 sin theta. For theta is equal to 60 degrees, cos theta is equal to half, and sin theta is equal to root 3 by 2. And for theta is equal to minus 60 degrees, cos theta is again equal to half, and sin theta is equal to minus root 3 by 2. We can put the values of cos theta and sin theta in this point and hence get the final coordinates of the point of contact of the tangent with the ellipse. Hence in this question we learned three things. If we are having a common line tangent to two curves, what we can do is, we can either write the tangents equations for both the curves एंड इक्वेट देम और रादर कंपेयर देम. द अदर मेथड इज वी कैन राइट द इक्वेशन टेंजेंट फॉर वन ऑफ द कर्व्स, पुट वाई इन टर्म्स ऑफ एक्स इन द सेकंड कर्व एंड पुट डिस्क्रिमिनेंट इज इक्वल टू जीरो फॉर दैट कर्व. और इन अ स्पेशल केस ऑफ अ सर्कल व्हाट वी कैन डू इज वी कैन ड्रॉ परपेंडिकुलर फ्रॉम सेंटर ऑन द टेंजेंट रिटर्न फॉर द सेकंड कर्व एंड इक्वेट इट टू द रेडियस ऑफ द सर्कल एंड हेंस गेट द फाइनल आंसर एज 4 cos theta, 16 upon root 11 sin theta as the point of contact of the tangent with the ellipse, where cos theta is equal to half, sin theta is equal to root 3 by 2 for the first tangent, and for the second tangent, it is cos theta is equal to half and sin theta is equal to minus root 3 by 2. And this is our final answer.